Hey y'all, I'm here at the home of the Texas Rangers, 2023 World Series champions, and we're about to do a championship trophy tour and go around and see the stadium and everything that has to do with the World Series. So check it out.
Little housekeeping, this is what's going to happen. We're going to go on a tour of the ballpark. At the close to the end is where you're going to see that trophy. At any time, you're happy and free to take any pictures as much as you want. If you need me to take pictures for you, or Jeff, we're happy to. Beware, I'm going to take a lot. Because out of one of them, all of those, one will be good. You can delete the rest, okay? So I'm happy to take any pictures with you. If you have any questions or comments along the way, please ask. Please say them. I'll try to answer them to the best of my ability, okay? All right, I'm going. Perfect. Welcome to the third hole of the 2023 World Series champion Texas Rangers, everybody. Woo, yes. So this is our third home. Our second home is across the street right there. It is now called Club Tone. I'll talk about that a little bit later on. But where we're at right now, down to the ground, is 50 feet down. They excavated 1.3 million cubic yards of dirt. If you want to get closer, you can look at that. And when they excavated, it went down to the local landfill. That grass down there is not real grass. It's artificial turf. And artificial turf, not with black beads, but it has coconut husk, sand, and fiber. So when the ball hits, it's brown dirt coming up. Now, before every homestand, they're going to brush it, they're going to water it. When they do that, it plays as natural grass. From center field to the top of the roof, 278 feet. From second base to the top, 210. And from home plate to the top, 193 feet. Nobody has hit the roof during play. Or that scoreboard that is 131 feet from the field. The outskirts of that field, crushed red brick for the warning track. And the infield is Dura-Edge with a little bit of kitty litter. Now, you'll see our mound in the middle. The pitching mound is retractable. Ourselves, as well as Tampa Bay, have that. Because other things happen here besides baseball. We have concerts, we have rodeos, we have football games. So we need that mound to go down, make it flat, so that we can bring stuff in and it's flat for whatever we're having. Now, over here where it's T-Mobile, to your left, and over here on the left field pole at SeatGeeks is a sign, those seats retract out. When they retract out, we're able to bring those 18-wheelers in so that they can unload their materials, and then they go back out, we put the seats back down so that fans can watch. At the top of the roof, take a look. It is the largest single panel roof in the world. It opens as one unit, and it opens from Globe Life Field, from east to west, back to those lights right there. And it goes like this. They push the button, they turn the key, they put their finger in. It is a fingerprint reader. Four people have that job. I am not one of them. Now here's your guessing game. How many minutes does it take to open up that roof?
14, 7.
Anybody else?
30.
I was going to give numbers, but you're going to give
30.
5. If you unclamp it,
3 minutes.
It's going to take 12 and a half minutes. But the actual roof just moving, 9.5 minutes. So once they put their finger on, 9.5 minutes it's hanging there until it opens all the way up. Yes, ma'am.
Why don't they open it?
So, when we get around the other corner over here, I'm going to tell you about the parameters, because we have parameters.
Okay.
Now, last night, what I heard on the radio, they didn't open it because humidity was high, and they were unveiling the championship flag, okay?
Okay.
And it would be like... Okay, follow me this way. We'll keep talking some more along the way. Jonas Main Concourse is things that are making back to our program. And the Rangers 2007 Right here is Adrian Beltre. We'll talk more about Adrian Beltre. All of you are going to know Hall of Fame. We'll talk more about those accolades now. Right here is Coach Rodriguez. Now, Coach Rodriguez is a catcher with us. And out of all Major League Baseball teams, 30 of them, all the catchers, he's caught the most games, 2,427. I'll talk more about him as well. This is our newest addition, y'all. This is our World Series champion picture and the jersey with the gold trim. You'll keep coming this way.
Okay. All right, over here, she just mentioned Johnny Oates to the left. And then American Championship. In the years that we won it, 10, 11, and 23.
Senators. Now, even if you weren't at the game one of the World Series in 2023, you've probably seen this picture right here along the way. Who is that, anybody?
Garcia.
Nolan Garcia. Do you know that he defected from Cuba in 2016? Then in 2019, he was with the Cardinals. They DFA'd him. That means they got rid of him. He was a free agent. The Rangers took him. The Rangers DFA'd him. And not in 2021, not till Ronald Guzman got hurt did he get his opportunity to come up with the Rangers in 2021. And that's what we got from two times being DFA'd. So I'll talk more about him as well along the way.
All right.
Now our next stop is going to be over here with two murals. It's called Went and Took It, because our slogan last year was Go and Take It. And we did go and take it because we finished it up with Went and Took It. And right here, if you want to get a shot of that, is the World Series Championship.
Truck.
Thank you. And sometimes the truck that was here last year was the truck that they rode around in at the World Series parade.
Nice.
You can please watch your step. They're trying to get things ready for what's going on in the next couple of days. Well, try to stay out of the way. These are two of our latest murals. This one right here is an aerial view of Adolis Garcia hitting that walk-off home run in game one. Here he is right here going around the bases and all the guys running in. And this is a picture of Corey Seager and Adolis. Now, if you're a fan of Rangers or know about it? 2011. Anybody know about 2011?
World Series versus Cardinals.
One strike away twice. And then Freeze hit that walk-off home run against us. And we lost that game. But our chance to win the World Series. To the date, 12 years was the walk-off home run by Adolis Garcia. Corey Seager tied it up in the ninth inning. Adolis Garcia hit the walk-off. Take pictures if you want. I'll meet you right over here. That's when you go to the All-Star Game. Golden Glove is when you win the Best Defensive Glove Award, Defensive Award each year. Silver Slugger, Best Offensive Award, okay? And then Hall of Fame is the best of the best of the best of the awards you can get. Kind of like winning the state championship spelling.
And she said an All-Star is when you go to an All-Star game.
So this is another one of our announcements. Corey Seager. That's when he hit that game tie-in, two-run home run in the bottom of the ninth. It was the first pitch. It was one on, one out, and he hit a 94-mile-an-hour fastball out of here at a velocity of 113. And it was with 464 feet, I believe it was.
Jeez.
Now, he's a two-time World Series MVP, right? Four people have won the MVP twice. Sandy Koufax, and then Reggie Jackson, and Bob Gibson. But he's the first person to win the MVP in the National League and the American League. 2020, he won it with the Dodgers. 2023
boo.
With us.
Boo the Dodgers.
Hey, we can't say that. Adrian Beltre. Adrian Beltre played with us from 2011 to 2018. He played third base, and he was a joy to watch.
There he was.
Now, he's my favorite. Now, he went into the Hall of Fame this year as the fifth Dominican Republican, and he has the stats for most hits for a third baseman with 3,166 and 477 home runs. Now we're fixing to go up some elevators, folks. We're going to be in two or three different groups. When you get upstairs, if you can please wait, don't wander off from me. I appreciate it. We have different fonts, different colors.
All the jerseys we wore since 1972, different.
So you're
colors
going to see our powder blue that we wear on Sunday. We have our blue, our gray, and our white. City Connect is on Friday and Saturday night. And that is a jersey to connect the city with the team. Every 3 years, they are redone. Anybody want pictures in front of this? While I'm talking, you can take some pictures. Now, when we play at a different stadium, we're going to wear our jersey that says Texas. When we play at this stadium, we wear the one that says Rangers.
Ah, okay. Good
Does
to know.
Does anybody know if it's not a special night, military night, Powder Blue Sunday, City Connect Friday and Saturday, who gets to choose what color jerseys they wear?
Pitcher.
Which pitcher?
Starting.
Starting pitcher is the correct answer.
Just waiting for some folks to take some photos here in this mural. If you look, we were just down there and saw the bell tray. She was talking about the little one down low, and then that one. 300 rooms here, 800 up there.
I don't know. Maybe they do. Maybe they don't. Anybody else?
All right. Now we got it. All right.
It's our one and only club.
She's talking about Carbach.
All other clubs have specialized tickets to get in there. So if you have a ticket over there, you can come to this. If you want to, take a seat in the rocking chairs. I'll talk to you a little bit about that.
I'm going to put you right here. There's the car buck. What's up, bud?
Are the rocking chairs at the Carbach area? These were first come, first serve. Our first year we opened. That was in 2020 because that was a year of COVID. It was first come, first serve, meaning you could sit there. But if you got up to go to the restroom, get something to eat, I'm sliding into your seat. As you can imagine, that caused a little bit of havoc. If you notice on the back now, they're section number, seat number, you have to purchase these tickets. They come in great. groups of twos, fours, fives, tens, and twenties. The neat thing about them is there was a guy named Alex Smith who played in our AAA system, and he, once he stopped playing, he opened up the Rockerman of Texas and built all these chairs.
Wow.
Now we have three video scoreboards here. One of them is the largest across the way, 58 by 150. Above you is our second, 40 by 120. Our third, not a good angle right here, is running vertical in center field. It's 80 by 20. When we get around the corner, I'll show that to you again. But that came from across the stadium, across the street. It was in left field and ran horizontal. So a nod of the hat, they brought it over here. Now, in a little bit, I'll talk about field dimensions. Right over there on right field, pole is 326. You're not going to see that number, but remember, it's there. Not a test. I'll talk about it. You got 20 seconds to rock. Good one, isn't it?
Rocking. She just said here at Carnbach, the baked potatoes are delicious, and so is the peach cobblers. And they have $4 beers from the gates opening until first pitch on Friday and Saturdays right here at Carnbach. So if you want $4 beers before first pitch on a Friday or Saturday game, go there. Condiment section. Oh, look at the view of the Cowboys Stadium.
Now, we talk about that roof, folks. That roof opens as one unit, and when it opens, it rolls out on 120 wheels. 60 over there on those arches, brick arches, and 60 wheels over here on this last set of trestles. When it comes out, it's an expanse of 5.5 acres. It covers this parking lot right here. And for us to have it open, here are the parameters. It cannot be hotter than 85 degrees outside. Colder than 65. Winds no more than 20. Cannot have rain, obviously. But one of the big things is humidity combined with the dew point. Our first year, learning curve. It was open. Humidity was high. Condensation was on the floors. What happened? People were slipping and falling and getting hurt. All those parameters together makes us be able to open it or keep it closed. Last night, humidity was high, and also the banner unveiling, I think, was what. Now, last season, we had it open 11 times, one time in the postseason. We have control of it during regular season. Postseason, MLB has control. But I'm sure they still use the parameters, so we've got to keep our fans safe, right? Now, that's Jerry's world. But we don't talk about Bruno, so let's go. To the right is the championship celebration on that November 1st date. I remember 52 years as Texas Rangers and 63 as a franchise counting those Washington Senators.
All right. Oh, excuse me.
If by chance you come to the game, you'll find me right here in section 209 and 210. Come by and say hi.
Hey, I found you there last night. That's where I sat last night.
No, we sat in section 138.
Bam.
Did they have other murals up here?
Yeah.
Did they replace something?
So this was replaced.
Okay.
So this lady just asked if this was a replacement mural. It is. The person they had here was Charlie Hump. Charlie Hump was our pitcher for 10 seasons. Remember, Nolan Ryan, I mentioned 5 seasons earlier, and everybody thinks Nolan Ryan is great. He is great. But for a Ranger pitcher, Charlie Hump threw the 56-mile-per-hour knuckleball. He had the most wins as a Ranger pitcher, 139.
Wow.
And most complete games that you don't see very much, 98.
Golly.
That's crazy.
Complete games.
Because everybody goes about 5 innings now, and then they're done, right? Speed things up, folks. We're fixing to go down the elevators right here. When we get down right on this wall, right below us, it's going to be the All-Star logo if you want to take pictures till we get everybody down there, because we have to keep moving quickly, okay?
All right.
It's going to be the 94th one.
We're hosting All-Star game.
Across the street, we hosted the 66th one. As a franchise, this will be our third time to host it. Washington Senators hosted in 69. And then 95 and 2024. Anybody
I'll be here.
Coming to the All-Star game?
I'll be here. Am I the only one?
We've got a lot of festivities starting on Friday night all the way through to, I believe, the
Tuesday. Not to the general public, not yet. Yeah, Lone Star members get priority. So. All of our group here in this tour.
All right, folks, as we're taking pictures, I'm going to keep talking. We're fixing to head to the next spot is Chuck Morgan's booth. Chuck Morgan is the public announcer. He has been working with us since 1983. Last night's game was a consecutive 3,245 games. Anybody else need a picture? So, when he had his 3,000 consecutive win, Major League Baseball asked.
They asked for his microphone. It's in Cooperstown.
Anything that's given away. Hats, jerseys, bobbleheads. We get over here and you'll see two display cases. And those display cases, a lot of memorabilia. Take a look real quick. Pop one out a few things, okay?
All right. There's the memorabilia straight ahead in those boxes. Shadow boxes or cases. We happened to walk by last night, and he just came out to get a picture with him quickly.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
So in this first display case is more memorabilia that's been autographed and given to him. You'll see Nolan Ryan's 5,000 strikeout scorecard that he autographed, Adrian Beltre helmet, Pudge Rodriguez glove. This microphone right down here was across the street, 1995 All-Star Game, 2010-2011 World Series. Also, there's some pictures, I believe, with the president. Newest information up here is all these memorabilia from the World Series this past year. And on that side over there is some more accolades given to him, his 2000th game, his 3000th game. You'll see his scorecards and his bobbleheads. Now, if you look in here, you might see some cards that are typed up. So he's the public announcer. Anything you hear before the game, during the game, after the game, is him. Makes up his own writings. He doesn't let anybody else write up anything for this.
This is so cool.
So take a look, and I'll talk about his working area. Please be careful for going on.
There's his office. And the other display case. Bobbleheads all over.
Table right there is Nolan Ryan's negotiation table. Nolan Ryan pitched
Nolan Ryan's negotiation table. Baseball lamp is pretty cool. World Series banners. This is so cool.
So every time, I mean, he's been working with us since 1983. Always new stuff. As of today, this right here for me is new. I went and took his sneakers. They weren't in there the other day when I went by. He's always putting in new things.
She said, if you get lost, you can look up and see where you're at on this lower concourse. That's a home plate right there.
A quick video about our original stadium. Ferguson Jenkins, he's in the Hall of Fame as a Chicago Cub, but he played with us. He was in our team in 1974 as a turnaround game. And he had 25 wins in 1974. Also, if you like ballpark nachos, we did not invent the nachos, but we were the first Major League Baseball team to sell them. Now, we talked a little bit about Nolan Ryan. Nolan Ryan had his seventh no-hitter at that stadium, the original stadium. And that means no hits, no runs. And this picture over here by my friend Jameson is Nolan Ryan and Robin Ventura. Nolan Ryan was 46, Robin Ventura, 26. There had been some scuffling between the White Sox and the Rangers. What happened? They were throwing at the batters. The White Sox manager said, if you get hit, you must charge the mound or it's $500 fine. So if you watch the video, Robin Ventura gets hit, he stands there for a second, and then he charges the mound, right? Nolan Ryan was a Texas boy. He was ready. He was a fighter. Grabbing Rancher like a steer. Now, here's
got that knuckle out.
If you're a good baseball player, you might get two hits, maybe three hits a game, right? Robin Ventura, six hits. And one inning off of Nolan Ryan. Right. That's when he grabbed it and said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, he was ready. We're going to go this way.
All right.
Now, when the gate's open until batting practice is over, if you don't have a ticket to this area, you're able to come down here. After that, you do not have access down here. Remember, card lock, anybody that had a ticket could go in there. Here, once you come in this area, please watch the ballot. You have to have a ticket to this area. This is one of our other clubs, the Speakeasy, specialized tickets to get in there. It's not a hat in the rich history of Arlington. It used to be called Vegas before Vegas because there is some prohibition going on here in Arlington. This girl right here is called Going Home by Ariel Davis because the horses are heading towards home plate. Now, all the artwork in our stadium is by local Texas dealers. There are 18 pieces with 14 different artists. And where we're fixing to head now is into the founder suite. So if you come in, take some pictures, sit down. I'm going to talk about the field dimensions.
Rangers Lounge.
Founders Lounge. There's another mural. Founder suite.
This is what I'm talking about.
Oh, wow. Let's go this way.
Wow.
So please don't video.
All right.
So please no pictures and video of the players out here, but come down here and take a seat. I'm going to try to open this one up over here.
Okay. I'm going to use them as a shield so I don't see the players.
Yeah, she did. Very flirty.
That's so cool. Oh, we're about to go over there, I'm sure. Just look at this stadium.
This suite is awesome.
Take you quickly over here to Nolan Ryan's corner, and then we're going to backtrack and go down to those elevators and go down to the lower bowl so you can get some good pictures. I'll talk about build dimensions there. But as we're going this way, you can take a look at this timeline around the way. This is from the stadium across the street. It's called Choctaw now. It was our second home, and nothing is wrong with that stadium. Structurally, it sits like this. It cannot hold a roof. We desperately needed a roof, so they built this stadium. Things still happen at that other stadium, because what? We promised to the city of Arlington. $1.2 billion was the cost of this stadium. Arlington put in money, Rangers put in money. And when that happened, we said things would continue to happen over there so the revenue can bring in. Some highlights right here is Kenny Rogers. He's our one and only Texas Ranger with a perfect game. No hits, no runs, no walks, no errors. Pudge Rodriguez was his catcher. Original base from the Interleague. Interleague happens all the time now, but that base is 15 by 15. New bases are 18 by 18.
Mm-hmm.
This guy right here is Gary Matthews Jr. Made a phenomenal catch, stole a home run from those Houston Astros. Now, one thing you don't know about him, maybe, or you do? Anybody know anything about Gary Matthews Jr.? Okay, do you know this information about him? There are 14 players in Major League Baseball, all of Major League Baseball, that has a natural cycle. That means a first at bat, they get a single. A second at bat, they get a double. A third at bat, triple. Fourth at bat, a home run. 14 guys have done that all time. He's one of them.
Wow.
Now, there's a lot of players with cycles all over. Adrian Beltre had 3 cycles at one stadium. Anybody want to guess what that one stadium is?
Across the street.
One time as a Seattle Mariner, twice as a Ranger.
Awesome.
And this I like to call jubilation. There was a guy named Alex Rodriguez. When we signed him on, he said, I want to get you to the World Series. And he did. But he was wearing a Yankees uniform as pitcher, Neftali Feliz. Threw it to catcher Benji Molina, and he watched that third strike go across. And when that happened, we went to the 2010 World Series. Now, we didn't win it. We lost to those Giants, who was managing by Bruce Bochy. And now,
we have
Bruce Bochy is our manager and got us to that World Series.
Heck yeah.
On this back side right here, you're going to see the Nolan Ryan. Come on down.
Oh, yeah, we're going to get a picture with that.
Take some pictures if you want. Now, Nolan Ryan pitched for 27 seasons, and in those 27 seasons, 7 no-hitters. He had strikeouts of 5,714, with 1,176 different individuals.
There's a bench right here. She was just talking about it, but I was taking pictures of Nolan Ryan bobblehead, so I didn't catch the information she said on that. But that's there. Cool little hallway over here.
I don't know if you mentioned this bench. It came out of the dugout from the old stadium.
Oh, nice. That's what the information was. I just missed it. All right, now we're going to go down. She's going to talk about field dimensions. Now you're going to have to get out of the wheelchair and walk in. Uh-oh.
But they were prepping for it.
Okay, sad news.
Banner's not there.
It was there a while ago. I took a picture.
So can come down just a little bit forward.
Oh.
You'll see those numbers, right? 42. Then we have 34, 26, 7, 29, and 10. Those are all the jerseys that have been retired. Now, to honor those players, our field dimensions are that. Our field dimensions happen from home plate to that back wall. If you look on the left field pole, you'll see it says 329. 29 is for Adrian Beltre. And then next to him is 334. 34 for Nolan Ryan, that great pitcher, Hall of Famer. Left field is 372. 72 is not a jersey, but that's the year we became a franchise. 1972. On either side of center field, 410. 10 for Michael Young, that all-time hits leader, 2,178 hits. Most games played by Ranger, 1,823. dead center, 407. Seven for that Hall of Famer, Pudge Rodriguez. 14-time All-Star, 13-time Golden Glove, and 7-time Silver Slugger. Now the bullpen door is open. It's 374. That's the turnaround, gang, with member Ferguson Jenkins had 25 wins. Help us turn around. 73, we had 57 wins. In 74, we had 84 wins.
Scherzer's in there pitching.
And if you remember from Carbach, over here on this right field pole, it's 326. Johnny Oates, the manager that got us to our first playoff appearance. Now, number 42 is up there. We're not going to forget about number 42, Jackie Robinson. From home plate to the backstop is 42 feet. Major League Baseball is typically 60 feet from there. They gave us special permission because we were honoring all of our guys.
Okay.
Take a quick picture if you need to, but we got to go downstairs. Oh, my gosh, we're not going downstairs. We are going to the trophy, y'all.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Classic suites are in the middle to the corners, and then the party suites are in the corners of each.
We're in the suite
right level. And left field.
That's pretty cool.
This is a mural of our original stadium, our second stadium, and our stadium here. And we're going to go down this way. Our first stop, as we pass by, we have a new showcase out of old things from the 1995 All-Star Game and the World Series. Some display cases. We'll walk by now, take some pictures if you like, and then we will go to that trophy area. Right here to your right is the life-size mural of that guy. That's the all-time hit singer, Michael Young. He also holds the stats for most doubles, 407, most triples for the Rangers, 55, most runs scored, 1,057. And sometimes, if you're in the right place at the right time, in the 2010 World Series, at batting practice, and he cracks his bat and slides it across the dugout, you might get it and take it home as a fan.
Nice. I'll go down this way.
Now, in this sweet area, you're going to see some pictures taken as well. Right here is that perfect game from Kenny Rogers, his scorecard. And this is a picture of Kenny Rogers. Right here is a picture of Juan Gonzalez. They called him Juan Gon because he would hit those home runs. He holds the stats for the most home runs by a Ranger, 372.
Wow.
And right here is my favorite. Great guy, Adrian Beltre. Four-time All-Star, five-time Golden Glove, two-time Platinum Glove, and four-time Silver Slugger. Pudge Rodriguez in his Hall of Fame speech. And this is Nolan Ryan, Mr. Rodriguez, and I believe that's Toby Hara. Mr. Ryan as well. Playoffs across the street.
That's Ron Washington.
American League Championship. That's Mr. Michael Young batting in the World Series. My left, your right, is a mural of the guys in their gold jersey. So we're fixing to go to that trophy area. I need everybody's attention on this one, please, so I don't get in trouble. When we get in there, you're going to line up, and you're going to go up and take a picture. You're going to take a picture like this. You're going to take a picture like this, selfie. I suggest taking a picture inside like this, and I'll tell you why, in the down part of the trophy. You can take a group picture. Take as many as you want because this is your chance to do it. But we're not allowed to touch the trophy. We're not allowed to touch the table that the trophy's on. Okay? After you take your picture, you'll just hang out. Everybody gets their pictures taken, and we're good. I'll give you some fun facts while we're in there about the trophy as well. You got any baseball buffs in here that might know some answers?
Maybe.
Okay. Any questions? Perfect. We're going to go right over here to this one of these suites to go in. That's where they have it today.
All right.
A large life-size mural of him.
Ian
in 2009 and 2011, he was a 30-30 guy. 30 stolen bases and 30 home runs. He was a four-time All-Star. He now works with our higher-ups as well as Pudge Rodriguez and Michael Young.
Speaking of Pudge, he's right there on the wall.
Here, wait,
There we go. Oh wow, there it is.
All right, folks.
You do the pictures,
Cindy. Yes, sir. So here's the deal. This is a new spot for us. Oh. It's kind of convenient. So if you'll take your picture, then come hang out right over here for me. That'll be great.
Okay. There she is. What a beauty.
Are you the trophy taker around her?
He's the coordinator. His name is Jeff.
Jeff. Nice to meet you, Jeff. Cindy. The base is 11 inches. From the bottom to the top of the flags is 24 inches. There's 30 flags because there's 30 Major League Baseball teams. Inside is longitudinal lines, latitudinal lines of the world with the gilded stitching. That's the gold stitching of the baseball inside. So that's why I said take a picture like that, okay? Approximate weight is 30 pounds and it's made by Tiffany & Company. Approximate cost, $20,000.
Jeez.
Yep. All right, let me just say, because for me, this was the first time that was this small. It's made by Tiffany & Company. It weighs approximately 30 pounds. Cost is approximately $20,000. The base, 11 inches in diameter. From the base to the top of the flags, there are 30 flags. It's 24 inches. 30 flags because there's 30 teams, right? This is our trophy. Nobody else is going to get that trophy. It's not like the Stanley Cup and goes from place to place. So each year, it's made and it goes to that team. Now, you can do whatever you want to on this one. The Rangers put, it has 2023 on it, and on the back side, it says Texas Rangers. Some people put all 30 names of the teams on the flags. Whatever your team decides to do is what you can do on that. Now, if the Rangers players choose to get a replica to have at their house, a full size is about $16,000. And mini is $11,000. Now, not till 1967 was the trophy given out. Before that, in 1903, it was emblems. Then in 1926, was a ring by the Cardinals. And then after that, was consistently given out rings. So until 1967, all they gave out was emblems or rings. The first team to get the trophy is, does anybody know, 1967? Cardinals. And there are three teams that have won it four times since they started handing it out. Anybody know that?
Baseball Yankees. Yankees.
Yankees have won it seven times. So that was my fault for phrasing it like that. There are three teams that have only won it four times.
Only won it.
So it is the
Cardinals.
Cardinals.
Dodgers.
No. Dodgers. Three times for the Dodgers.
Red Sox.
Red Sox.
Red Sox.
The acronym is CAR. So we have the Cardinals. We have the Red Sox.
Angels.
The team with the A.
Angels.
Athletics.
Athletic.
We're gonna go this way, y'all.
They can't win to save their life now.
Remember when I talked about Jim Sundberg? That's a great catcher. But right there is that catcher, Pudge Rodriguez. 14-time All-Star. Sorry about that.
There's a kid in the way.
And right here to your left is one of our newest girls. This is Marcus Simeon. Marcus Simeon plays second base for us. And he holds the records from last year from 835 plate appearances. And he played in all 179 games last year.
Jeez.
So earlier somebody asked me who could be my favorite player, and I said previously, old school, because I've been around for a while, Pudge Rodriguez. Nowadays, Marcus Simeon. He has great work ethic. Always out there working out all the time, trying to make himself better and for the team.
There's some sweets. There's right field.
And as we go around this, down this aisle right here, you're going to see some more pictures. Nolan Ryan. These are all local artwork from the Texas dealers. Rusty Greer. He was an outfielder that made an amazing catch to keep that perfect game of Kenny Rogers going. And then there's that great catcher, Pudge Rodriguez. next one is Juan Gonzalez. Juan gone. In 1998, he had 101 RBIs at the All-Star break and finished with 157. Right here is Michael Young. And then our last one is Adrian Beltre. Now, one of our newest areas right here is the Comerica Backyard. New area where you can come in. We're going to go around this way, that you can get drinks and just hang out and watch the game.
And it's on
4,000 square feet. It's from the Texas Patio Live idea.
It's as big as a house.
I haven't been here yet to see what happens because my section is up there, but I'm sure it's bustling when the game is going on.
And it's on turf. That's cool. There's the old Choctaw across the street. The old Rangers stadium, the ballpark in Arlington. Live at Lowe's out there, the new Lowe's Hotel. Here's the
So folks, we're fixing to go down these elevators right here. Jeff, otherwise I'm going to take you down these stairs. If you want to go with me down the stairs. When we get down there, you're going to see that vertical scoreboard that came from across the street.
It's right here.
Right here. And you'll see how large it is. But we're going to finish at the team store. And if you happen to purchase anything in there, they have selected items that you can get 10% off. So when you get in there, if you bought something earlier, you can go back in. You'll get your 10%, your coupon for the with the tour. Yes, sir? Is it on?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You can go down the escalator.
That's fine.
So if you're going to go down the stairs or escalator, follow me. If you're going to go on the elevator, you're going to go with Jeff. And then we'll see you for coming and touring home with those 2023 World Series Texas Rangers champions. And we're going to exit out right this way right here. And hopefully I'll see you at some of the games.
All right. Thank you, Cindy.
All right. If you like that tour, go ahead and subscribe to my channel, please. I appreciate it. And follow me, watch some of the other videos. Appreciate you tuning in and checking out the video. Take care, have a good day.